You all know Oliver Slope. He's with Blue Line Futures, and he joins us right now to take a look at our markets as we wrap up the month of November, but begin a new trading week. It's a little bit confusing today, but he'll help us sort it out. He joins us right now. Oliver, we have downward pressure in the grain markets today, and let's navigate the prices here, and then I want to get your take on what we're looking at. With the quotes provided by Bar Chart, March corn down 2¾ at 431. It's just kind of been hovering in that area for quite a while this morning. Soybeans, similar action. January down 14¾ cents at 1177 per bushel after hitting a high overnight of 1199. So obviously 22 cents off of that. If you look at the soy products today in the soybean meal trade, we have January down $4.10 at 392.20. That would be per ton, of course. On the soybean oil trade, we have January down 73 points at 37.70. On the wheat market, right now in Chicago, we have March trading 15 cents lower, all the way down to 5.91 after almost hitting 6.10 overnight. Quite a turnaround there. In the Kansas City market, you have March down 14¾ at 5.50½ per bushel. In the Minneapolis market, you have March wheat down 11¼ at 5.58¾. So let's talk about this here, Oliver. With all this bearishness around, is there something weighing on everything, or what do you think is contributing to all the bearishness today?
Well, we saw a great open last night across the board, corn, soybeans, wheat, all trading a little bit higher on some reports that South America was going to continue to be dry. We're getting kind of some conflicting weather forecasts down there. So this is very much a weather market that is focused on South America and their potential production down there. And that's going to keep the volatility alive and well. You throw in the end of the month, and that adds volatility to the fire here a little bit. And you're seeing a little bit of profit taking, likely feeding on itself here today. And we wouldn't be surprised to see that volatility really stick around for the remainder of the year, because once we get past this month, we're looking at the end of the year, and you've got a lot of funds who have built up a big net long position in some of these markets. And they're looking at, you know, capitalizing on the move, booking gains to try to boost assets under management next year. So I think that's going to be something that has been overlooked here maybe recently, but going to be a big focus going forward as we do look towards the end of the year.
Now, I did see where an agency out of Brazil actually reduced their corn and soybean production estimates by a little bit, not quite a million tons, but it doesn't seem to have any impact on the trade here today. So it must be taking a back seat to the positioning then.
The fundamentals right now are taking a bit of a backseat. And we also saw some exports this morning, about 13.5 million bushels of corn, some to unknown, and that's really not helping the market get a bid. So we are seeing money flow take control of the market right now, and I wouldn't be surprised to see that continue through today's session. If we post a high in the overnight session and don't see that follow through momentum early in the morning, that's typically not a good sign, and it likely leads to more long liquidation, and I wouldn't be surprised to see that continue. 1175 is a big kind of pivot point for us in this January soybean contract. If we break and close below there, there's a little bit of a gap closer to 1155. That would be our next downward target. Again, 1175, if close below there, opens the door for that gap fill.
One side note, I did see where China has apparently approved importing grain sorghum, but not from us, from Mexico. So maybe that's a little bit of a factor in there, too. Of course, they have been big buyers of U.S. grain sorghum earlier.